Please state your name and your occupation and where you work.
Donna Barica. I'm a nurse practitioner and I work for JPS Health Network in Fort Worth, Texas.
In your practice, what are the three most common types of pain that you see in your patients?
Our practice is divided really into three groups. Malignant pain, non-malignant pain that is related to musculoskeletal disease, and non-malignant pain related to HIV disease.
And what are the complications in dealing with pain management?
As far as types of pain we see a lot of neuropathic pain related to treatment from treatment for the malignancies, as well as treatment for the HIV. And then we see a lot of neuropathy related to radiculopathy from musculoskeletal pain, as well as we just treat a lot of axial pain. And that we treat primarily with intervention treatments.
I see. Can you tell me anything about the courses you've attended so far? A favorite or?
This morning I attended the one on the new complexity model. That was very informative because our health network is instituting the patient-centered medical home this fall. So that was very interesting to me because we are setting up such a model for our pain practice.
Oh, good.
So that was very helpful to me. I just finished attending the session on depression and suicide. That was an extremely good session and very, very informative. We do see a lot of mental health disorders associated with our pain practice, and it's especially the musculoskeletal pain. And it's always been a question for me is what came first, the chicken or the egg? And I've always suspected that it was the pain that came first and the mental health disorder that came second. And I think that was validated in that presentation. Another one that I attended that I liked a lot was the pharmacotherapy session on pain management. That was a very interesting presentation about the other effects of opioid therapy that you don't really think about a lot. I was very well aware of the endocrine effects, such as the lowered testosterone, but not so much the effects that chronic opioid therapy could have on the growth factors in cancers and the depression of the immune system. We're all well aware of the opioid-induced constipation. So that's a very common thing. But the other two, were new to me. So it was very interesting to learn about that. And then the fibromyalgia session this morning was just outstanding. I enjoyed that. Long, but outstanding.
Is this your first pain week?
This is my first pain week, and I will be back next year.
I'm very glad to hear that.
And this is an excellent, excellent venue. Mm-hmm. I hope it's held here next year.
I believe it is next year.
Because this, the Cosmopolitan has been wonderful. The facilities are comfortable. Yes, some things are a little pricey, but I had to buy some things down in the sundry store down on the first floor, and they saved me $20 by saying, no, you don't want to do that because you can get that free from guest services.
Well, isn't that nice?
So that was extremely nice, right. Instead of selling me something I really didn't need.
Right. And I assume you attend other conferences?
I do.
And how would you say this one compares?
Very favorably. As a matter of fact, there is a nurse practitioner conference annually in Colorado and that I like to go to but haven't been for several years. And this is very much on a level with that. It's far better than some of the other conferences I've been to. So
well, thank
much,
you.
Much better.
Well, thank you very much for speaking
with
us.
Well.